morning children. I hope you all will be fine. So today I am going to take social science for you. In social science, term 1, lesson number 1 is kingdoms of rivers. What is the meaning of kingdoms of rivers? Which kingdom ruled near which river bank? That is the meaning. Learning objectives. What are all you are going to learn from this lesson? To know about Tamil kingdoms of Sangam age, to know about Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas, to understand the administrative, economic and social conditions during the Sangam period, to know about Kurunila Mannargal. So these are all the things you are going to learn from this lesson. Introduction. In the ancient period, what happened? People went and settled on the river banks. They produced the agricultural crops. They reared cattle in the pasture land. In this way, the early Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas and other kingdoms emerged along the rivers. So in this way only, the early Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas and other kingdoms emerged along the rivers, means they lived along the river banks. So see here children, I have kept the pictures of Moovendargal, Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas and their flags. Okay, so their flags was, Cheras flag was, it consists of bow and arrow. Cholas flag consists of jumping tiger and Pandya's flag consists of fish. So kingdoms rivers, which kingdoms ruled near which river bank? Cheras Poigai, Cholas Kaveri, Pandyas Vaigai, Pallavas Palar. Now we are going to learn about Cheras in depth. Okay children, Cheras is one among the Moovendargal. So Cheras is one among the Moovendargal, that is Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas. They ruled near river Poigai. Their capital city was Vanji. It comprised of the districts Erode, Tirupur, Coimbatore and Nilgiris. Kerala was also a part of it. It is called as Cheranadu and major part of it was surrounded by high mountains. Why it was called as Cheranadu? Because it was ruled by the Cheras. So it is called as Cheranadu and major part of it was surrounded by high mountains. Okay children, the greatest kings among the kings of Cheranadu were Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan and his son Senguttuvan. So who were they? Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan and his son Senguttuvan. They two are the greatest kings. Okay children, Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan and his son Senguttuvan. The Chera king Nedunjeralathan went up to the Himalayas and hoisted their flag with the symbol of bow and arrow. Therefore, he was hailed with the title Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan. Okay children, why this Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan got this name as Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan? Because his name is only Nedunjeralathan. What happened one time? This Chera king Nedunjeralathan went up to the Himalayas and what he did? And hoisted their flag with the symbol of bow and arrow. He hoisted their flag over there. Therefore, he was hailed with the title Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan. So only he was hailed with the title of Imayavaramban Nedunjeralathan. Cheras. Cheras River Poigai. Their capital Vanji. Port Tondi and Musiri. Their flag bow and arrow. Next we are going to learn about Cholas in depth. Okay children, The early Cholas kept Urayur as their capital along the river Kaveri and ruled it. So for Cholas, which was their capital? Urayur. And they ruled along the river Kaveri. The Chola kingdom comprised the districts of Tiruchirappalli, Tanjavur, Pudukottai, Nagapattinam, Tiruvarur, Perambalur, Ariyalur and Kudalur. Okay children, so these are all the districts in the Chola kingdom. Districts the Chola kingdom comprised. The land of Cholas was very fertile. The greatest ruler among the Cholas was Karikala Cholan. Okay, so in this Cholas, who were the greatest ruler? The greatest ruler among the Cholas was Karikala Cholan. So, we are going to learn about Karikala Cholan in depth, children. Okay. Karikala Cholan became king in his early age and ruled efficiently. So, he had become the king in his early age and ruled efficiently. When he was very young, he was captured by his enemies and imprisoned. Imprisoned means arrested and kept in a room. Okay. A room alonely. Okay. Lonely he was kept. Arrested and kept in a room lonely. The room which he was arrested was set on fire. In this fire accident, his feet burnt. What happened? In that fire, one room he was arrested and kept, no? In that room, they were set out full of fire. In this fire accident, his feet burnt. Due to his charred leg, he was called as Karikalan. So, due to his charred leg, he was called as Karikalan. The Cheras and Pandyas together attacked Karikalan and finally Karikala Cholan defeated them both and was victorious. He was victorious and won the kingdom at the last. He invaded Sri Lanka and brought the captives from there to build the dam Kallanai across the river Kaveri. The dam still stands erected even after 2000 years of its construction. So the dam does not got affected by any of the natural calamities. Okay children, it still stands erected even after 2000 years of its construction. Next, Cholas River Kaveri, capital Urayur, port Kaveri Pumpattinam, and their flag consists of tiger. Next, we are moving to Pandyas. Pandyas ruled on the bank of River Vaigai with Madurai as their capital. The ancient Pandya country comprised of Madurai, Theni, Dindukal, Virudhunagar, Tirunelveli, Chittikorin, Sivagangai and Ramanathapuram districts. Pandya country is famous for pearls. Muttamil Sangams were held in Madurai under the patronage of Pandyas. The most famous kings were Thalayalang Ganath, Seru Venja, Pandya Nedunjalian and Pandya Nedunjalian of Silapadigaram. So Pandyas is ruling near which river? Vaigai, and their capital city was Madurai. The ancient Pandya country comprised of Madurai, Theni, Dindukal, Virudhunagar, Tirunelveli, Chittikorin, Sivagangai and Ramanathapuram districts. Okay children, Pandya country is famous for pearls. So their country is famous for pearls. Muttamil Sangams were held in Madurai under the patronage of Pandya. So Muttamil Sangams were held in Madurai. The most famous kings were Thalayalang Ganath, Seru Venja, Pandya Nedunjalian and Pandya Nedunjalian of Silapadigaram. So now we are going to learn about Silapadigaram. So next class I am going to continue about the Silapadigaram.
Hi children, now we are going to learn a memory poem, My Robo. Now from the last lesson you would have got some idea about the qualities of Robo. Now this is the poem. I will read it for you. My Robo. I have a robo big and strong, big and strong, big and strong. Watch now how it walks along with a nice rhyming song. I have a robot smart and tall, smart and tall, smart and tall. Watch now how it welcomes all with a nice greeting call. It has wheels go front and back, front and back, front and back. Watch now how it keeps the sack in every little rack. Never it takes food and rest, food and rest, food and rest. Watch now how it works it best with all same zest. My Robo. I have a robo big and strong, big and strong, big and strong. Watch now how it walks along with a nice rhyming song. Here the author says that he has a robot which is very healthy and strong, much stronger than human beings, much powerful than human beings. Here author says that his robo walks rhythmically. What is the meaning of rhythmically? That means robots walk in rhyming way. That is as if his robo is singing a song. I have a robot smart and tall, smart and tall, smart and tall. Watch now how it welcomes all with a nice greeting call. Author says that his robo is very smart, tall, and it greets everyone in a pleasing way. It has wheels go front and back, front and back, front and back. Watch now how it keeps the sack in every little rack. Robo has wheels fixed to its legs. It walks in such a way it looks as if it has some sack on its back. Never it takes food and rest, food and rest, food and rest. Watch now how it works it best with all same zest. It never takes food or rest because it is a machine. This means full of enthusiasm, eagerness to do the work. Okay, let's switch on to the meanings. The first one is strong. What is the meaning of strong? Powerful. The spelling is P-O-W-E-R-F-U-L. Powerful. Strong, powerful. The second one, watch. Look at. The meaning of watch is look at. L-O-O-K, look. A-T, at. Look at. Watch, look at. The third one is smart. S-M-A-R-T, smart. What is the meaning of smart? Fashionable. F-A-S-H-I-O-N-A-B-L-E, fashionable. The fourth one is zest. What is the meaning of zest? Eagerness. E-A-G-E-R-N-E-S-S, eagerness. Children, we'll move on to the next one is rhyming words. The first one is tall. Tall, all. Tall, all. T-A-L-L, tall. All. A-L-L, all. The second one is song, along. Song, along. Song, along. S-O-N-G, song. A-L, O-N-G, along. Song, along. The third one is rack. Sack. Rack, R-A-C-K, rack. S-A-C-K, rack. The fourth one, rest, best. Rest, best. R-E-S-T, rest. B-E-S-T, best. So, rest, best. These are the rhyming words. Children, I hope you all have enjoyed the session. We will meet on the next class. Bye.
Hello children. This is your maths class. Let's see unit 1 in geometry. What is geometry? Geometry is a branch of mathematics that deals with point, line, surface and solid. Do you know where do we use geometry in real life? When you need to build or create something, geometry play an important role. Now let's see the properties of plane shapes. Different plane shapes have different number of sides and corners. Sides. One of the lines that make plane or a flat surface is called a side. Vertex. The point where two sides meet or intersect is called a vertex. Now, let's move on to the topic of two-dimensional shapes. Plane shapes are those that can be drawn in the flat surface, such as paper. It has two measurements, length and width. So, it is also known as 2D shapes or two dimensions. Square, rectangle, circle, triangle are called plane shapes because they are flat. Square, rectangle, triangle, circle are the examples of 2D shapes. Square. This is a square. A square has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the sides of square are equal. A square has four vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. The example of squares are clock and dice. Rectangle. This is a rectangle. All the sides of the rectangle are not equal. Opposite sides of rectangle are equal. A rectangle has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. It has four vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. The example of rectangles are blackboard and television. Triangle. This is a triangle. A triangle has three sides. 1, 2, 3. And it has three vertices. 1, 2, 3. The sides of a triangle can be same length or they can be different. The example of triangle are angle and chips. Circle. This is a circle. Does a circle has vertex or sides? No. Circle has no vertex and sides. It is a closed loop. The example of circle are football and moon, clock and dice, rectangle. This is a rectangle. All the sides of the rectangle are not equal. Opposite sides of rectangle are equal. A rectangle has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. It has four vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. The example of rectangles are blackboard and television. Triangle. This is a triangle. A triangle has three sides. 1, 2, 3. And it has three vertices. 1, 2, 3. The sides of a triangle can be same length or they can be different. The example of triangle are angle and chips. Circle. This is a circle. Does a circle has vertex or sides? No. Circle has no vertex and sides. It is a closed loop. The example of circle are football and moon. Let's move on to the topic of quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means four sides. Quad means four, lateral means sides. A quadrilateral is a 2D shape that is closed with four straight sides. This is a quadrilateral. A quadrilateral has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it has four vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. The example of quadrilateral are rectangle, square, rhombus, parallelogram. Each of the shapes are made of four line segments. Such four-sided closed figures are called quadrilateral. Square, rectangle, rhombus, parallelogram are the different types of quadrilateral. What is this? This is a triangle. Is this a quadrilateral? No. Why? Because a triangle has three sides. Hence, we know a quadrilateral has four sides. So, a triangle is not a quadrilateral.
Let's see the properties of square, rectangle, rhombus and parallelogram. Square are formed by line segment. We already know square as four vertices and four sides. Here the vertex are named as A, B, C, D and the sides are named as AB, BC, CD and DA. The diagonals are named as AC and BD. Diagonals is nothing but a line segment
that goes from one corner to another. Square has equal sides and equal diagonals. Rectangle. Rectangles are also formed by line segments. Here the vertex are named as B, C, D, A. And the sides are named as BC, CD, DA and AB. Opposite sides of the rectangle are equal. BC equal to DA and DC equal to AB. BD and CA are two diagonals. BD equal to AC. Rhombus. This is a rhombus. Rhombus has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. And four vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the sides of rhombus are equal. The example of rhombus is kite. Let's see the properties of rhombus. Rhombus are formed by line segment. Here the vertex are C, B, A, D and the sides are named as CB, BA, AD and DC. The diagonals are named as DB and AC. All the sides of the rhombus are equal, but the diagonals are not equal in length. Let's see objective based on the concept of quadrilateral. First one, all closed four-sided figures are called quadrilateral. Second one, a square has four equal sides and equal diagonals. Move to the third one. The opposite sides of a rectangle are equal. Fourth one, a circle has no sides. Fifth one, diagonals are equal in square and parallelogram. This is a parallelogram. A parallelogram has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. And four vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal and parallel. The example of parallelogram is eraser. Properties of parallelogram. Parallelogram are also formed by line segment. Here the vertex are named as B, C, D, A. And the sides are named as BC equal to AD and CD equal to AB. Opposite sides of parallelogram are parallel and equal in length. Let's see the objectives based on the concept of quadrilateral. Here the first one, all closed four-sided figures are called quadrilateral. A square has four equal sides and equal diagonals. Third one, the opposite sides of a rectangle equal. A circle has no sides. Diagonals are equal in square and rectangle.
Hi children, how are you all? I hope you are keeping good.
Today's class will be based on my body. Our body is a wonderful machine. It consists of two parts that work together. They are internal organ and external organs. First, let us learn about external organs. External organs mean organs that are found externally. That is, eyes, ears, nose, mouth, and legs. Now, have a look at the external parts of a body. Hair, eye, nose, shoulder, elbow, arm, finger, leg, foot, forehead, ear, tooth, mouth, neck, chest, stomach, hand, knee, ankle. All these are external organs. Now we can move on to the internal organs. What are the internal organs found in a body? They are lungs, liver, kidneys, stomach, brain, heart. Let us learn about the internal organs in detail. We will start with the brain. Brain is an important organ. It is protected by the skull. Brain has three divisions. They are forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Looking at the picture, you will be able to follow the three different divisions. The front part of the brain is called as forebrain. The middle portion of the brain is called as midbrain. The hind portion of the brain is called as hindbrain. Brain is known as the commanding center of a body. All functions like sitting, feeling, thinking are controlled by the brain. Next, we will learn about our lungs. Lungs are spongy hair sacs situated in the chest. There are pair. That means one on the left side and one on the right side. Lungs help us to breathe. Inhaling air is breathing and exhaling air is breathing out. First, let us learn about breathing mechanism. Breathing in means taking in oxygen through our nose and that passes to our lungs. At this stage, lungs expand. Secondly, when we breathe out, carbon dioxide is given out and thereby contraction takes place. Next, let's learn about the stomach. It is J-shaped, found below the lungs. Inside the stomach, there are many enzymes. They are digestive juices. The digestive juices helps us to break down the food and convert into energy. Next, we shall learn about a heart. It is a pumping organ. It pumps blood to all parts of our body. It is located in the center of the chest. It is made up of muscles. Blood circulates throughout the body. Example, if you get hurt anywhere in the body, blood comes out from the particular place. This is because blood is circulating throughout the body. This circulation is done by the heart. Now, let's learn about kidneys. This is a bean-shaped organ. Kidneys purify blood by filtering excess water and toxins. Toxins means poison. Now we can move on to the bones and muscles. Our body is made up of bones and muscles. Press your upper arms. The portion that feels hard to touch is the bone. The portion that feels soft to touch is the muscles. The bone gives us shape. They are the frame of our body and allows us to jump, run, or just lie down. Bones also protect the internal parts of the body. Muscles are the soft parts that cover up bones. They help us to move different parts of our body. In order to maintain a healthy bones, we need to have healthy food such as milk, cheese, and eggs. For strong muscles, we need to exercise and stay active. I hope you have all understood this lesson. Thank you.